coach Beth. Thursday, 3 o'clock, almost 3 o'clock. Almost didn't make it, but here I am. I was running an errand and got a little delayed. So here we are. Welcome to my backyard. There's my chair. I'm gonna go have to get my seat cushion, but you get the idea. You got an armless chair. You got some weights, whatever weights you've got around your house. They could be hand weights, free weights, cans of food. I've got my kettlebells there, my trusty, kettlebells. There went my water bottle. And perfect segue, you want your water bottle, but you don't want it to fall on the floor. So grab your water and last but not least, I want to get my music on. So let's get that going. Stay with me while I change my music. I'll be right back. Hey, I'm back. Sorry that took me a second. There we are. Oh, you know what I need to do? I need to get my earbuds lined up with my phone. I'm back now. Sorry about that. I forgot I can't use AirPods and the speaker at the same time. So we're gonna just opt for the speaker and the music. Come on back, folks. I know I had more people watching live. Come on back. All right, I can hear the beat. I hope you can. If the music drowns me out, please let me know. All right. Have a seat. There we are. I don't have my cushion, but that's okay. We're gonna stay right here. Sit on the front edge of your chair. Knees right in front of hips. Sit tall. Nice proud chest. Reach your arms out. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale down. Let's do it again. In front. Exhale. Open. Inhale. Exhale. Let's try it again. Open. Pop straight up and then down the front. In. Open. And lift. Exhale down. Two more. In. Open. Then up. Inhale. Exhale straight down. One more. Open. Bring them up. Lower down. Good. Let's go ahead and run those arms with the beat. Push those elbows back. Thanks for joining me today. Whether you're joining me live or later on, I appreciate it. I want to keep this ball rolling. It's really important to keep your mobility, keep your strength. It beats stress. It beats the metabolism creeping in, the slow metabolism creeping in. It's good mentally and spiritually. Just lifts the spirits. Keep going. Keep your hips anchored. Keep your feet anchored. Okay, we're going to double time our arm swing, making it a little more challenging to stabilize on your chair. So let's go a little bit faster and try not to let your body wiggle, wobble, twist. Keep going and keep the breath open. Good. Stay with it. Four. Three. Two. And relax. Deep breath up. Only raise the hands as high as the shoulders are comfortable. Exhale, lower down. Let's try it again. Inhale. Exhale down. Floating arms. One more time. Deep breath. Really expand the body with that inhale. Exhale. Grow a little taller. There we go. Hands on the thighs. All right. We're going to warm up the backs of the arms, warm up the shoulders. As I do these, I want to keep my body very straight, very rigid, and then push away from the thighs. Use your arm strength right behind your upper arm, push back. When I bend my elbows, I'm keeping them close to my waist. Push it away. Sit up tall. Great. From the side, check out my posture. I'm hinging forward. The back stays straight. Push up, push up, push up. Do it again. Down. Elbows close to your sides. Push up. And again. Hinge. And push. Hey, with that hinge, use that as an opportunity to pull in your belly. And push. Right from there. Down. Two. Three. And four. And press. There we go. Good. All right. Facing you again. I'm going to swing my arms this time together, forward and back. Be careful on the back swing that you're not hitting or bumping into your chair. You should be far enough forward, actually, on your chair seat to steer clear of the chair back. Okay? We did this on Tuesday. We're going to freeze and push. Two more. Swing the arms. Back. Hold the elbows up. Push the hands towards me. Two. One. Swing the arms once. Hold. Push the palms to me. Two. One. And again. It's one swing. Hold the elbows out in front. Two. Only raise your hands and elbows as high as your neck and shoulders are comfortable. And I don't want my elbows out here either, right? One swing. Hold. Push. 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 And a swing. Push. Push. One more set. One swing. Three. Two. And one. Let the arms just swing freely. That's a nice flush out right there. Good. All right, we're going to swing the arms seven times. On eight, you're going to stand up. Here we go. So it's seven, six, five, four, three, two, ready, up you go. Use the momentum of the arm swing. I'm going to have to get my cushion. That's no. Okay. Hold on a second. Okay. Now give me a thumbs up if you can hear me. I'm guessing there's some sort of interference going on with my AirPods, my speaker, and my phone. So thumbs up if you can hear me. Awesome. Okay. We're just going to keep it no music today. My apologies. I'm not going to sing at you, but we're going to still move. This way you can focus on the cueing. Yay. Thumb, 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 thumb. I love it. I appreciate the feedback. I'm glad you're here because I would have never known. Okay, thanks guys. That means I can sit a little closer to you. Let's try that on. All right. It takes a village, telling ya. Takes a village. Let's try this again. Now, when I sat down, I don't know if y'all saw that, but my knees went, you. We're gonna try not to let that happen, okay? It's just a funny habit. I just, I guess I got lazy there for a second. So that tells you that we want to be really conscious and aware of how we're moving. We want to energize the outer hip and thigh, whether we're standing or sitting. Get your feet in underneath you so that when you swing those arms after three reps, we're going to stand on four. All right, so here it is. 3, 2, 1, and up. I was talking about hips. As you press the hips forward and stand up, my shorts aren't telling the whole story. There we go. I want my hips to line up right under my ribs, right under my shoulders. I don't want to stand and do that, because that shortens my low back, very painful over time. Find neutral when you stand. All right, you ready? Carefully sit down. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and up. Sit back down, find your target, and 3, 2, 1, ready, up. Okay, that's straight up. Now as you sit down, keep the chest proud. Sit the hips back over your target. There we go. Did you see the knees? They lined up that time. 3, 2, 1, ready, up. The other thing I want you to watch out for is locking your knees. Don't let that happen. Sit back with the chest proud, hips back. And 3, 2, 1, ready. Lift with your tummy, lift with your legs. Push those heels into the floor and relax your toes. Sit back. That's what I call a lunar landing. 3, 2, 1, and up. Lunar landing, sit back, sit slowly. There it is. And again, 3, 2, 1, throw the arms up and sit back, lunar landing. There we go. And 3, 2, 1, ready, up. Okay, now I'm gonna add this layer. When you stand up, not only are we squeezing the glutes, the hamstrings, I want you to think of squeezing a ball between your ankles. Not so hard that that happens, right? But we've got this upper inner thigh energy that's helping to strengthen and stabilize and solidify your posture, which is really gonna help with balance over time. So let's get those stronger. Sit down into your lunar landing. Okay, and you're ready? 3, 2, 1, and up. Squeeze that ball between the ankles. I hope you feel that engage in the glutes. Sitting back, hips over the box. Sorry, that's a chair. 3, 2, 1, and up. I keep saying it's feeling like Friday, and that must be mentally where I am, because you're noticing the result. 3, 2, 1, and up. Squeeze. Upper inner thighs, there we go. Now sit back with those abs, hips, lunar landing, and one more. 3, 2, 1, and we're just developing our strength for our squat and the lunar landing. There we go, very nice job. Right hand on the shoulder, left hand out in front. They're gonna trace straight lines forward, straight lines back. As I bend the elbow, let it just sink down past your waist. Sit tall and push and pull, pull and push. Find your breath now. It's never a good time to hold your breath unless you're underwater, snorkeling in the Bahamas. Push and pull. Oh, are there hurricanes down there right now? You probably don't want to be snorkeling, but I'm not a big snorkeler myself. That mask just boxes me in. Let's do four more. And 3. Scoop out those abs. 2, and 1. There we go. All right, we're gonna stretch those wrists a little bit. So I want you to reach the right arm forward, fingertips down, and just gently pull those fingers towards you, ever so gently. Okay, and we're feeling all that nice stretch in the wrist and forearm. As you go there, try not to go there. Slide the shoulder down, and then pull on the hand. You don't have to hold it as high as I am. You can just bring it down. And easily stretch the wrist. Let's stretch it the other way now. Fingertips up. Gently pull the fingers back. This is certainly not anything you want to do forcibly or for too long. Just nice, several deep breathing cycles is sufficient. And you should be feeling that now here, those wrist flexors. And woo, shake that out. Let's do the other side. Fingertips down. Pull the fingers back towards you. Take a deep breath. I'm going to check in with my shoulders, make sure they're sliding down the back, and that my core is still strong and stable. It's keeping my posture correct. This is the last time, the last place you want to be sinking and slouching. This is the time to build the posture and train the body to stay in this posture when you stretch and exercise. Let's flip the fingers up. Show me your palm. Pull the fingers back again. Because when you start to let go of your posture and your support muscles, your core, and then begin to stretch and exercise around a crooked framework, that's when we get into trouble. Things become malaligned, our balance gets thrown off, the joints aren't tracking well. You can imagine all the stuff that can go wrong. And that's why I'm always talking about proud chest, shoulders over ribs over hips, and we're gonna twist. Left arm over right, take a deep breath. Shrug your shoulders up to the ears and then gently bring them down. Make sure they're correct. We're gonna twist to the right for three exhales. So as you twist, progress a little more on two and a little more on one and inhale forward. Twist left, three, a little more, two, a little more, one, inhale front and right, three. Grow taller, go stronger and one and three. Make sure you're not bouncing to get farther, but you're rather reaching and engaging around the waist, around the ribs, to increase your range. You're also trying to grow taller out through the spine. One more set to the left. So sit taller and inhale and lower down. So as you were feeling as you went, I want you to notice how the breath really can facilitate a better rotation, a little more power and strength to get you to where you want to go without hurting yourself. All right, let's get a drink of water. Thought you'd never ask. Water time. All right, let's get onto some weights here. Let's go ahead and stand up. Now remember, when you pick anything up, doesn't matter if it's weights, heavy, light, whatever, I'm gonna step my feet one in front of the other, make sure I don't hit my head on my chair. And I'm gonna bend my knees and hips to pick up the weight so that I can keep my head above my hips and heart, okay? So here's your weights. Yours might be lighter, yours might be heavier. Either way, it's fine, as long as you can safely execute the movements that we're doing and effectively. All right, so let's talk about some bicep curls. Keep your elbows right next to you, but not leveraged against you. And just lift the hands up to the shoulders and lower them down. Exhale, pretty basic bicep curl, right? But we're gonna make it a little fancier. I'm gonna step forward a little bit and lower. Palms press up to the sky, lower back down. Pressing up. I'm gonna gently squeeze that imaginary ball between my ankles as I work and not lock my knees. Two more reps. It's a curl and down and a curl and down. Put those weights on your chair for just a moment. Shake out the arms. Okay, let's energize mid-back muscles. By strengthening our mid-back muscles, it allows us to lengthen the thoracic spine, the part of the spine that runs from my neck down to my rib cage, through my rib cage, right about there until it meets up with the low back, right? That's the part of the spine we want to elongate while we do this particular exercise, the right arm is going to go high on the diagonal, the left arm is going to go low. When I reach that arm, that high arm, make sure you're not squeezing up above your shoulder. If anything, you're squeezing below the shoulder, and you're going to press the backs of your hands towards the wall behind you. And when you do that, just make sure that that doesn't happen with your ribs and chest, okay? Keep all of that neutral. Bend the elbows, fingertips touch, reach again. It's like you're just creating this diagonal line or this sash across the body there. And reach. And bring it in. Okay. Now, I'm not sure if you could hear me during that phone call. I didn't take the phone call, but when a call comes in on my phone, I lost you, and I hope you didn't lose me. So let's try the other side. Let's see what else can happen today. Left arm high, right arm low. Okay, find your mid-back muscles. Squeeze the shoulder blades just barely together, just barely. We're not going for that, but we are going for that tone. Okay, and then think of sliding the shoulders down your back. Can you see my palms? They're facing you. Yours should be facing me. Bend your elbows. Reach open. Bend your elbows. I want you to exhale when you stretch the arms apart. I want you to keep those ribs against your body when the arms reach. Okay, that's a really powerful posture to keep and maintain, especially as you add load. You're adding load by reaching the arms away. And I'm very chatty today. Reach. It's a good thing the music's not working. Three more. Actually, I wouldn't be chatting this much if we had music. So take your pick. More music or more talk? I know there's radio stations that really pride themselves on less talk, more music. But I think you're going to get more benefit today from more talk. Let's do one more. Stretch the fingertips away and then touch them together and shake out the shoulders. I'm going to let the dog out real quickly. Here we go. There he comes. Come on. It's okay. Have you met my dog? It's a good day to meet the dog. This is Jones. He is my guy. Cutest guy I ever met. He's just the cutest. So that's Jones. I'd love to meet your dogs someday, or your kitties, whatever you got running around. We're gonna do that same exercise here, but on a, thank you. We're gonna pulse the arms this time. I'm gonna turn to the side and raise my right arm high, my left arm low. You're still reaching, radiating energy out through those fingertips. Now as you reach, pull your belly button in and up towards your rib cage. Okay, that should really give you some nice low back support so that we don't end up arching. Now pulse your hands back and pulse. Very gentle, very subtle. It's that subtlety of gently squeezing the shoulder blades together across the mid-back, but not full range. This is small because I want to keep my bones in the same place. My ribs don't move and shift. Neither does my spine. Three, two, one. There's some heat. Roll it around as we turn to the other side. Roll those arms around. Now the left arm goes high, the right arm goes low, and we're going to pulse the hands back and back and back and back. Let's do four more and a three. Here's two and one, and bring them in and woo, spin the arms the other way. Spin them the other way. Okay, with that, oops, he's right there. With that arm spin, we're gonna go foot to foot. I want you to shift your weight to each foot. If you don't trust one foot, knee, or hip, then modify this and more keep it in the center so that you can keep your weight on both feet, okay? I certainly don't want you to buckle a knee or have pain in your hip. All right, rolling those shoulders around a little bit, let's reach the right arm across the body without hiking. Slide it down, hold on to that arm across your chest. Feel free to stand or sit. Either one works here. We're gonna go back to those bicep curls, and that's where we're gonna make it a little more fancy. You wanna make sure that you've got good traction on your feet. I don't want you to be wearing some, you know, leather bottom shoes on a carpet or anything like that. In fact, if you've got a mat, you might wanna use that if you're on a slippery surface. The left arm is across the body now, and we're letting that shoulder slide down the body. He's my guard dog too. Vicious. Oh. Let's stir those arms a bit. Now the stirring comes from the shoulders. If you've been in class before, you know this stretch. I love it, love it, love it. You're gonna hinge. So the spine is straight, right? My hips are back. You don't need to see my hips though. I want you to see my shoulders and arms. My spine is long. And I'm gonna stir the arms in opposite circles. Let the momentum carry the arms around. It's as though you're holding on to heavy weights in your hands. Let's go the other way. Just let that momentum stir yourself around. Three, and two, and one, and stand up. There we go. Okay, pick up your weights again. We're gonna do a bicep curl with a little bit of a step, a reverse lunge, okay? So what's gonna happen, and let me advise you for balance sake, you're welcome to hold on to your chair back, okay, as you do this, and just hold on to one weight, all right? But if you're holding on to two, just try this very slowly. Come up halfway with your weights as you step the right foot back. There we are. That wasn't far enough because I want to lunge. And then you're going to curl, stand, and together. Switching feet. Step back. Weights come up halfway. Curl, bend, stand, and together. Back, down, up, together. Back, down, up, together, and halfway with the weights, all the way, halfway, together, half, up, half, together. One more on each side. I know these are pretty challenging if you're not holding on to something, together, and we'll do one more, up, together. Weights right in front of you, right in front of your thighs. Without sliding the shoulders up to the ears, push your elbows out wide, lower down. Elbows wide, down. That's all I want to cue here. And if you're just pushing your elbows out wide, sliding the weights up in a straight line, down in a straight line, well then your shoulders, hopefully, aren't shrugging. Eight and down. Seven. You're welcome to stand in a split stance here. Here's five. Chest proud. And four. Two. There it is. One. And down. Very nice. Put those guys down. Now we're gonna try that same lunge, this time holding on to your chair, okay? That way, I want you to feel successful in your lunge. I want you to feel like this is something you can do, and we're gonna do it well. The chair's gonna help us do it well because it's gonna keep our upper body very vertical. So right now I'm centered right behind my chair. I want you to get there also. Step back with your left toes, reaching back. It's a fairly big step. It's in line with your hips. So you're on railroad tracks right now, not a tightrope. Railroad tracks, okay? Now we're gonna bend both knees. Use that chair if you need to support a balance, but then use your legs, both legs at the same time, to stand back up. Now this is a correct lunge. When you bend the knees, that front knee stays over the ankle. Modify it if you need to. And stand up. And bend both knees. The lunge must involve both legs. Both knees bend. This right here is not an effective lunge. That's a knee shearing, knee damaging lunge. Here you are. And it's okay to help yourself up with that chair also if your legs aren't feeling so great right now or if you're just tired. Do what you need to do to keep you in yourself in good form. If it's been a while since you've done a nice full lunge, definitely use that chair. Let's step together, shake the legs out, turn around. I just have to move. You don't have to. You don't have a camera to worry about. And thank you for your patience and being just so kind about my learning curve and a camera. Teaching to a camera is very, very different than teaching to a live crowd. All right, I can be a lot sillier with a live crowd, but here we are. Step back with your right foot this time. It's way back there, and it's in line with the hips, right? You're on railroad tracks here. Keep the chest proud, keep the shoulders down as you bend both knees, and stand up. The other thing that can tip you off to tell you that you're bending both knees is that your body moves straight down and straight up. It doesn't lunge forward, right, or back. You're just staying here, bending both knees and up and bend. Now you might remember the days when you could get that knee down to the floor. Maybe those days aren't so far away. Maybe you could get there again with a little more strength. But don't force it. Avoid shearing that knee by keeping it right over your ankle. Abs are strong and lifted. You're gonna do two more for me. And up now, step together. Oh, and shake those legs and hips out. That was fantastic. All right, we're gonna stretch the lower leg now. So I'm turning my chair to the side so you can see how I'm positioning this stretch. I'm just gonna skip that cushion. Okay? I want you to be able to see my back foot here. You're just gonna get your hands on your chair by hinging forward. Okay, there we are. Reach your right foot back. Step that left foot right in underneath your knee. And we're gonna push that right heel into the floor. Now we're gonna energize the calf by lifting the heel, push it into the floor. Now this helps us progress into a deeper calf stretch, but it also gives us an opportunity to create resistance and strength building for the calves, the ankle, and the foot. Keep your body in a straight line. That's a little slippery. It rained today, which was a very welcome change. Push, reach, push, reach, push, reach. Of course the crows want to join in. One more time. Push. And I'm waiting for the fire brigade to show up. Next. You're going to bring that foot in. Soften the knees. Stand up straight and tall. All right, we're going to go to the other foot. Right foot right there. Reach the left heel back. Find your balance and positioning. A little bit of upper inner thigh tension. Remember that tension you felt when you were virtually squeezing a ball between your ankles. That's the same feeling. Now we're gonna lift the left heel, push the heel away. Lift it up, push the heel. As you do this, this is a great opportunity to feel the gravity against your abs, right? It's pulling your abs to the floor. I want you to muscularly pull your abs back towards your spine without getting bunched up in your shoulders or rounding your spine. Now I got distracted. Now I'm really gonna reach the heel back. Oh, that side really needed it. Three more. push the heel back into the floor. One more, push it away. Okay, let's step forward. Here I am, still nice flat back. Put your hands onto your thighs and lift your body up. Good. All right, let's have another drink of water. One moment. Have another drink of water. Okay, back at you. There is one more exercise that I really want to hit today, and it's something you can do on your own, and I recommend you do it every day. It really strengthens the core without having to do 8 bajillion sit-ups, right? We all know that too many sit-ups really wears and tears on the spine in a way that we don't need. You don't have to do crunches to get a strong core. And a strong core will help you in every aspect of your life, okay? Every posture requires a strong core. But if you're aging, like we all are, especially balance, we need the core for balance. We need the core to help us respond or react a little faster to an unpredictable situation, tripping, ice, whatever it is, some obstacle on the floor that we didn't see, a slippery bath mat, anything. A stronger core will help you avoid a negative outcome. All right, so maybe you'll pull a muscle instead of breaking a bone. I think that's a good outcome, but hopefully none of those things happen. But here's the idea, is you got your chair. It's very important that you really apply your weight to the center of the chair. I'm gonna say this is your chair seat. This is the back end by the chair back. This is the front end. Go right in the middle. And then just let your fingers wrap around the sides of the chair. Okay, I'm hoping you can see that here. Now, to strengthen the core, this is your modified plank, okay? The abs are strong. When we stretch our legs out, which we'll do in a moment, we'll do it one at a time. But what I want you to do is to pull your navel back towards your spine until your spine is imprinting. Do you see how flat that got? And then I'm gonna release that now into neutral. I didn't let go of my tummy tension. I just shifted my spine up just a little bit. I didn't do this, okay, but it's subtle. So just scoop your abs up towards your spine and stop there. Now reach one leg away. Rest on those toes a little bit. Keep that spinal flexion and then bring that foot back in, okay? Try the other side. I'm still engaged. My abs are still drawn back. And there we are. I'm gonna put a little bit more weight on that left foot just to see that I can trust it. And I can start to feel that engage in the core, right? We're already building core strength by keeping this nice posture. Now let's release that little imprint to a neutral. There's my trough, okay? Now scoop again, pull the abs up towards your spine. Let's try 2 feet this time. So reach 1 foot away. And the second foot right next to it. And there's your modified plank. Okay, step in and control, and stand yourself up. That's your modified plank, gang, okay? Now, we're gonna do a set of 8. Stop whenever you need to. Sometimes your wrists are not gonna like it for too long. Maybe do 3 or 4 at a time. Stand up. Shake it out, and then do another 3 or 4 and call it good. And try that for a few days, okay? You'll build strength here and hopefully a little bit of endurance for the wrists and hands over time, okay? You could cushion your grip, okay, right there, putting something soft, but sticky, not slippery, okay? I'm really taking my time here with the safety cues because you're on your own. I can't be there to help you, monitor the situation. So it's really important that you are safe. You want traction everywhere. Here's your hands. Scoop your belly. Flatten your low back. Here we go. I'm going to keep going. Take a break if you need to. I'm going to reach one, two together. Step in together. Two together. In together. Three. And in. And maybe over time as you get stronger, that plank hold will get longer and longer. So this is for those of you who want a little work in a pinch, okay? You're in the middle of the day, you're getting a little drowsy, you're gonna try a few planks as you walk past your dining table. This is the exercise for you. I think I have about three more. Alternate your feet. You can mix this up any old way. But as you get stronger, maybe you'll hold that plank for 10 seconds and do that for a week, for maybe a set of 6, 7, or 8. Last one, I'm gonna hold this one. I'll give you one more cue for this. Not only am I imprinting my spine or pulling my belly up towards my spine, but I'm gonna squeeze my heels together. You should feel that on the upper inner thighs and glutes. It narrows the pelvic floor. That's good news. We could all use practice there. And then let's step in, bend your elbows to round your spine. Bend your knees, roll yourself up, all the way to the top. All right, well done. I'd love to hear your feedback on whether those planks worked out for you or if they work out over time. I want you to practice those. That's your homework for the weekend, okay? I'd like you to try at least one set a day. Really find your support. Keep those elbows micro-bent, okay? We don't want to lock them out. We don't want to lose circulation or overdo it on the joint. I don't want you to hyperextend that joint. So just a micro bend. That way you're using the muscles instead of the bones to stabilize. I'm so grateful you joined me today. Happy Thursday. I guess Thursday means it's our Friday since I won't see you again until Tuesday. So have a great weekend. Let me know what your progress is. If you have any more questions about the plank, okay? We've not done that before. That was a lot of fun. I'll talk to you soon. Take good care. 3 o'clock Tuesday. Bye-bye.